ang pag-ibig po ng Panginoon ay nakakalasing. At ako po ay nagpapasalamat. I am thanking God, bringing back the glory and honor unto Him.
Amen.
Amen. It is a great privilege for me to open up some pages of my life, and ako po ay natutuwa sa pagkakataong ito, sapagkat sa ganitong congregation ko po maisasabi yung aking mga testimony. Actually, I am thinking how I will start na kung saan di ko lubos maisip, kasi sa dami po ng aking experiences at saka pagpapalang na tango ko galing sa Panginoon. Maybe I will start way back on 2010. 2010, I am not yet a literature evangelist, but though I have some background, maybe a little bit, like I know that publishing department is existing in our denomination, but I don't know how they work, how they approach, how they do their job. But one thing I know is they are selling books, they are going house to house, and having a personal visitation to some people around them, or maybe in the far from their place. So yun lang po yung ating alam at first glance of my year way back when I'm going on starting sa aking sa aking paglilingkod po sa literature ministry sa ating publishing. Tumaas po ako sa Baguio for some convention, maybe if I'm not mistaken, it is some convention for the leaders from different school, Adventist school, like their president are there, like Dr. Dial, Sir Ramada, Dr. Flores. At that time, I just came with them there. I am a personal assistant of that time of Sir Gladden. I am just carrying his bag, going there. And then, as I listening to the talk that they have in their seminar, napansin ko na some young people from side of the conference hall there at the Mountain Promises Mission are gathering. They are talking or they are conversing something that related in this ministry. And then I noticed that some of them are AUP students. And then I am happy because on that place I have seen them. And it's something very unusual to see them in the parties like that. So, sabi ko, okay, malapitan ko. And makamayan ko man lamang. At masaya dahil nakita kami sa lugar na ito. And then, to make the long story short, we meet each other. Then we check the situation, if they are what they are doing there. What is their purpose there, why they are in Baguio. Then, they said to me, we're doing canvassing work this summer. So sabi ko, oh really? Malayo naman. Sabi ko sa kanila, napakaganda pala ng canvassing work eh. So yun po yung una ko nasabi. Then, to make the long story short po, ay marami kaming pinag-usapan. We talk so much that something na hindi po namin na-realize yung time. Ang haba pala ng napag-usapan namin. Tawag dito, that time, binisita ko sila sa kanilang quarter doon, sa Mountain Promise Mission. And then, at that afternoon, parang something na merong gumabagabag sa aking isipan. And something na I'm more curious now in the literature ministry. So, bumaba kami ng Baguio, natapos yung convention ng mga leaders from different schools, SDA school. And sa siguro sa pagbabagabag ng ano noong time na yon, I know that the Holy Spirit is the one who's coming to me that time. Na sinasabi, mag-join ka kasi napakaganda ng ministry na ito. Then, so, unconsciously, I found myself praying in the bus. I'm praying on the bus, I'm talking to God, Lord, if this is your will, I will work in the literature ministry. And at that time, I am working here inside the AUP campus as a working student from swimming pool department. So, 2011 came, after that summer, I decided on myself already na I will not work inside here. I will work as a full year round student literature evangelist. And my motto is God will provide that time. Though I don't know some reason na kung saan parang naisip ko, pero ang pumapasok lang sa isip ko is gusto ko, I want to be here in this kind of ministry. Because that time, actually, to tell you honestly, I was envy on those people who are doing this. It's because they are enjoying themselves, they have a free time to go on some places talking to people. Eh, I love to talk to people who is outside there na makarinig ng kanilang mga testimony. So, as time goes by, I found myself na ako pala ay pitin sa ganitong gawain sapagkat nai-enjoy ko siya. You know, hindi ko po namamalayan yung oras, hindi ko po, ano, I didn't realize how time goes by. It is because, maybe those times na kung saan pag nakakarinig ako ng story from different people life or different point of view, na-learn ako sa kanila. And then at the same time, eto po, yung pinaka-best education na natanggap ko dito sa Literature Evangelist. I am exposed to different kind of person who is from different culture, different background. And then I learned how to communicate to them. I learned how to handle their objections and some other thing na kung saan ay natutunan ko. Then also, I learned how to budget my money. I learned na kung saan ay maging disiplinado sa oras. I learned na kung saan ay yung lagi kang may preparation. And at the same time, what I want the most here is I am in the kind of ministry na kung saan ang Panginoon po ang inuuna. Amen?
Amen.
So, yun po yung pinaka nagustuhan ko sa lahat. Kaya, nag-canvas po ako for two consecutive summer, 2011 and 12, as a student literature evangelist. And then, those years, those times, I didn't care about my sales. I didn't care about my, what do you call this, the things that will bother me. All I think is kung paano ko magagawa ng maayos yung trabaho ko. Yun lamang po yung pinagpupusan ko. So, the canvassing work, some of my friends are, to tell you honestly, the other side of the coin. Some of my friends are, they are just careless. They are just happy-go-lucky. If it is happy in this place, they will go, but they didn't care about their responsibility like planning for their canvassing work field when they will go the next time. But me, on the other hand, I am convinced on myself na hindi ko kailangan magsayang ng oras. So most of the time, I have to think that the time is so precious. Time is so precious. That's what I calculated in my mind. It is because if I wasted my time, what will happen? I will mapapabayaan ko yung aking pag-aaral, mapapabayaan ko rin yung ministry na inentrust ako ng Panginoon. So, from the time na kung saan ay lagi ako nakakahulog, kasi actually, Ang kinahit ng aking first year college is 4 years. Working from different department on this campus. But when natapos ko na yung first year college, 2010 ay pumasok, 2011 pumasok na ako. Tag-iisa na lang, second year, third year, fourth year. So all in all, if you will sum up it, 7 years. 4 years working alone on first year, 3 years working on second year, third year, fourth year. So, I praise God natamo ko yun sa gawain na ito. So, hindi ko na malaya, ako po pala yung approach na po ng ating mga director from CLC. Sabi sa akin po ni Director Matira that time na nag-re-recruit sila dito sa AUP doon sa may right wing ng PIC. Ikaw nakikita kita mo lagi every summer eh. I always seen you. You are a potential leader of a student. You have to lead. Come on, we will approve you and then you have to recruit some student early and then encourage them to do this kind of work. Yun yung sinabi niya sa akin that time. So, in short, I accepted. So, yung remaining na 2 years ko, 2013 and 14 hanggang ngayon, student leader ng mga LAs. So, until na ako saan, I am not that skilled person when it comes to selling. I am just only diligent on my post. I am just doing what is best. I always guarding my post. What is entrusted to me, I will just do. I am not after the position, I am not after the money, I am not after those things. But like what our director on SSD said before this morning, that I came here because of Jesus. Yun lamang po. And always na nag-inculcate sa aking mind is yung nasa Micah 60. It says na, do you know, O man, what is right? And what was the Lord required of thee? But to do justly. Gumawa po ng may kaganapan. And then, yung post na yun ay ginagawa po ng may kaganapan as a student LE, as a student leader, those years that I am working, I enjoy. It is because, not on the good performance, but it is because of Jesus. So, yun lang po. Until to the time that is after summer, the CLC granted me for newly appointed team leader on the regular LE, student LE, and kung saan akin naman po pinag-iigihan din. And then, actually, if I will count those blessings that I have been received from God, I cannot count. To tell you honestly, many times that I am giving up, it is because the battle between good and evil is so hard. But I always remember, this is the ministry of God. This is entrusted to you. You must do it because it is not my battle. Yun yung palagi pag nangingin natin ako. It is not your battle. It's God. It is God, not yours. So, yun. Siguro, I encourage also some people around me na mag-canvas din. So, actually, literature ministry, all I can say in short phrase is a good work na kung saan, a second to none, na ang Panginoon, the only is the Lord, will be your guide. He will be always there. He will not forsake you. He will make you happy. And what about this? In short, pag-i-enjoying ka niya doon sa gawain na ito. Sapagkat marami siyang ituturong bagay sa'yo na once in a lifetime, walang makukuha. Yan lamang po, and I-encourage ko kayo, to those who didn't yet involved in this kind of work, this is the time. Maybe God is calling you also. And I pray and I hope na yung Holy Spirit ay kumakatok na ngayon sa inyong puso. At you will experiencing some kind of enjoyment na hindi nyo pa nararanasan before. It is because this kind of ministry, the angel will work to you side by side. And yung Holy Spirit ay hindi nyo mamamalayan na ito na pala ay nagpapaligaya sa inyo sa bawat sandali na nahirapan kayo. Yun lamang, and God bless you.